Welcome to another episode of Walleye Chronicles. In partnership with Smilin' Fish and Fix Productions. What is Walleye Chronicles? Walleye Chronicles is pretty simple. It's an oral history about walleye fishing told from every one of you. Not just me, not rich, poor, have a boat, professional, or weekend angler. It's told through every single person. So sit back and enjoy a conversation with today's guest, Jerry Tzakis. Jerry, how you doing?
Doing well yourself.
Tell me a little bit about your growing up, how you grew up. Well, background, yeah. All that kind of stuff.
So I grew up in Fond du Lac, and we were a fishing family. More or less, I would always go on our 16-foot Lund. We go on Winnebago, Cal Moraine, kind of all over. My dad was big into fishing, and my mom would come and enjoy the sun, more or less. So,
what'd they do? I think your dad was a cop and your mom is a teacher.
Yeah.
So sisters, brothers?
I have an older sister, and my mom worked first shift as a teacher, and then my dad worked second shift. So we didn't really have daycare. So a lot of times the daycare was us being in the boat.
That's pretty awesome. So what's your first fishing memory? The first memory you can remember on the water?
I think it's more because there's a picture of it, but when I was 5 years old, I caught 2 6.5-pound or 5 or 6.5-pound, I don't remember how big they were, walleyes back to back on Winnebago, and they put a picture in the reporter at the time.
Nice. See, in the future, those are things I have to make sure I get from you ahead of time, because to get that photo beyond, that'd be dope. So do you remember anything about it? I mean, other than the picture, are there any memories from that?
Well, my mom said, I was so little at the time. I think my dad was basically holding the rod, and then my mom was holding my pants so that I didn't go in the water.
So do you remember what you were doing? Was it trolling chicken?
We were trolling.
Trolling, cool. Do you remember what that was a long time ago. There probably wasn't Berkeley back then, but do you remember what it was?
I knew you were going to ask me that. I can't remember what it was. A blue Bagley. For some reason, those were just money. They stopped making them at one point, and we tried reproducing the color. And if you didn't have the original paint color, they didn't work.
Right. So have you tried to track any of those down over the years? Have you paid attention for them?
I found three of them, yeah.
Do you use them or just keep them aside?
I don't use them because on eBay, they're $125 a piece.
Holy mackerels.
So.
Would you use them if you had to? Like, say you're in a tournament, say you're fishing Battle and Bago, having a rough day, would you throw one on?
I think the memory's worth more than the money.
Is it? Yeah. That's fair. That's fair.
Because I haven't come across anymore. I found it at an antique shop, so.
Oh, that's cool. So you're purposely looking for them. You're getting to find it.
If I could find them, yeah.
I know. So a little backstory, me and Jerry used to work together. So we worked, I think, 12 years together, something like that, on those lines.
10 or 12 years.
So Jerry loves to find, goes to the oddest places to find equipment, and he loves kits and files. He randomly stops all over the place, like all of us do, to find lures at little hole in the wall spots. But Jerry, yeah, that's pretty awesome. He went and tracked them same ones down. So you had a Lund growing up, 16-foot Lund.
Yep.
What kind of motor?
Yamaha 40 horsepower.
Oh, Yamaha. Did it start, or was there like dad trying to get it started kind of things, or was it always a smooth?
It's still running to this day, and 30 years, you never had a problem with it ever.
Really?
Yeah, and it never burned any oil, really. I mean, you had to add oil, but like it would not use oil.
Electric start, pole start?
It was both.
Both? Okay. That's cool. What about the rest of the boat? Was it decked out? Was it?
It was pretty basic.
Did you have the three seats, or was it an open concept?
The front had a bench, and then there was the two seats in the middle. Okay. And then he would sit in the back typically because it's a tiller.
Okay.
So he liked it. The tiller was nice just because it gave you a little bit more space.
That's true. Yeah, you don't have the console in the way. Trolling rods all set up, or would just kind of like lean against the side?
No, he had rod holders and...
Homemade rod holders bought? Okay.
Bought one. But we kind of switched from, I don't know, Scotty. I mean, all different brands of rod holders.
That's cool. So was it pretty packed? So would you all go, all four of you go out? Was it pretty packed then? Or just you, him, and your mom? Or how'd that work?
We'd all four go at times. I mean, depending on, like, if the white bass run was on, then we'd, fill coolers of white bass if we could.
Coolers. That was back in the day when it was five walleyes. Did you guys ever put 20 in the boat together?
don't think so.
No?
No.
You shouldn't. But, you can't say it now because you probably, we could cancel if you said you took 20 walleyes out at a time.
No, I don't think that. No. Back in the day, I mean, I think it was a little bit harder to catch walleyes. I mean, it's sporadic. We didn't have like the GPSs and stuff.
I suppose you're kind of going off of no knowledge and not really new knowledge, I guess. You can't really track things down like we can today.
Yeah.
That's cool. Anything else crazy about the boat that was different that you remember that you have that sticks out in your head? Like
him and a friend, they welded their own live well.
Oh, did it work?
Because it didn't. Yeah, it works, and it pumped from the back, and but there was no live well in a Lund that old.
That's funny.
So it was 1982. I think he bought it right when I was born.
What color?
The red.
The red one.
Yeah,
that's red.
Let's go. It was the DV, so it was like the little bit deeper one.
Okay.
And wide.
Troll motor?
Just a Minn Kota on the back.
Oh. That's the way I was growing up too. We were always back trolling the river. Yeah. So most of your time was on Bago, Kettle Moraine, anywhere else?
Turtle Flamble Flodge when I got a little bit older with him, but.
Oh, that was fun. That's fun up there.
But for the most part, we went to Canada once to
take the boat along.
Yeah.
How was that?
Any issues? Good. Caught a ton of northern. He wanted to catch muskies and cause he primarily liked the musky fish. Well, he go to Elkhart Lake too a lot.
Okay. That's an odd one.
And then, when they had a lot of muskies at the time.
Mm, I gotcha.
So, but yeah, it was good.
That's cool. As far as, so you fished Winnebago, about what was your favorite location to fish back when you were a kid? What would you look forward to going fishing? Like your dad's like, hey, we're going to go out to here, this reef or that reef. Or what was your, when he said going fishing, what was the next thing that made you ears perk up? Made you want to go, oh, heck yeah.
I think it was more like he bribed me to go a lot when I was younger. So the whole thing was like, cause it'd be so early in the morning and he'd be like, okay, we'll stop at a gas station. You can pick out candy and a soda. So then as a collector, I'd used to like hang out. I wouldn't eat the candy, I'd just collect it, which is kind of a little bit different.
That is a little bit different, but I mean, whatever.
Yeah. So I mean, after a summer, I'd like have for a while it was all gum. I'd get different kinds of gum.
We didn't have any Quick Trick back then either.
No, there was a place, there's a couple places in Fond du Lac, and then there was right before Kettle Moraine, there's a gas station. It's like a 76 or Phillips, I remember. But yeah, so he'd kind of bribe us a little bit, but and then when I got older, it was more kind of collecting baits, I guess.
Oh, I gotcha. Yeah, that's a cool thing. I mean, I think people don't just sitting back and looking at your bait collection is kind of fun to me. Sometimes there's, you know, different colors, different things that are make it interesting. So what was your favorite bait growing up?
Well, the Wally Divers were popular. When I was like, I mean, we used to use a lot of those. And then the Bagleys. And then, well, we'd use Rapalas too. So
mostly trolling or do like
trolling,
bobbers, anything like that?
We did a lot of perch fishing too, but
okay,
that was just a jig and crawler.
I got you floating over the reefs.
Yeah.
That's cool. What else got for you? So, tell me what your, you don't really know what your first, what's your first memory of your, not your wall, the, you told us about the walleyes, but one that you actually remember. Like your first one that you can recall what happened, how it went down, all that kind of fun stuff.
That probably was, I think it was salmon fishing. I was in sixth grade just because of the size of it. It was a 25 pound king salmon.
Jeez.
My dad knew a guy and we went, he wasn't a charter or anything, but we just went with him for the morning.
That's fun.
And we did really well. And I remember I could barely lift it. It was so big. And so I got a good picture of it too, but like, I just remember it took a while to reel it in too. By the time I got it in, I could barely, I was so excited how big it was. So,
How do you remember fishing memories? So like everybody has like things that they see and it spawns a memory. What things spawn memories for you for fishing? Is it people? Is it weather? Is it lures? What kind of things kind of kick you back to when you were a kid?
I think like lures, probably weather, and then smell.
Smell.
I always think of everything like we're like a sense of smell. So like, I don't know, it might be a little bit odd, but like I like the smell of gas. but like, yeah, just the smell of worms. Like, I'm not saying I like the smell of worms, but like it just reminds me of fishing. Because and then we used to, my dad used to give us a nickel a worm too. Pick them at night after it rained.
Were you good at it? When you broke them, did you throw them on the ground or did you put them in there anyways?
No, I was pretty good at
it. Not break them?
Yeah, I was pretty good at them.
Okay. I know I have a Cooper. He would, a couple years ago when he was 10, when you break them, he would still put them in there and claim them as crawlers. And I'm like, but they're dead, Cooper. We can't use them. They're going to ruin the whole thing. So it took me a year or two to get him to go, okay, if you break, you got to leave them there and call it good.
No, my dad would like count them too with us and then... So he's pretty specific about it, but both my sister and I would do it at night, and we lived in the country, so it was like, you know.
So it wasn't so weird, a couple people out in the yard with flashlights?
It was a little scary at times, because you're like, you're out there by yourself, but at a younger age, I don't remember how old we were, probably, but we both did it. Uh-huh. So it was a little bit, a way to make some extra money.
Right, yeah, I mean, you get to use them going fishing, too. Right? Yeah.